Okay, Shalom Rastafari, greetings in the name of His Imperial Majesty, Haile Selassie I, the elect of God, conquering lion of the tribe of Judah, King of Kings of Ethiopia, and then through Jesus Christos, you know, Yeshua HaMashiach. So, we're actually gonna, okay, Rastafari, send that study number 17, we think. Yotor. We think it's Yotor. And so, Yitro. Yotor, Yitro. Okay, so there's one verse that we had to, you know, we give thanks to Wyndham Mandela. Wyndham Mandela, Haile Jesus. Because we actually were had a conversation on the phone, and this came up and kind of motivated I and I to bring this forth, and it has to do with our righteousness exceeding that of the Pharisees. And so, because it's included within Rastafari sent that study number 17, Yotor, and so it's within the New Testament readings, the Adis Kidan of Yemateus Wengel, chapter 5, verses 8 to verse 20. And give me just 1 second. Okay, so it says, whosoever there, and this is, we're actually going to begin from, we'll begin from verse 17, so it reads, and we're going to read from the Old Schofield Study Bible, so we get a title for this read, and it reads, Relation of Christ to the Law. And so think not that I am come to destroy the law, or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill. For verily I say to you, till heaven and earth pass, one jot or one tittle shall in no wise pass from the law till all be fulfilled. Whosoever therefore shall break one of these least commandments and shall teach men so, he shall be called the least in the kingdom of heaven. But whosoever shall do and teach them, the same shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven. For I say to you, that except your righteousness shall exceed the righteousness of the scribes and Pharisees, ye shall in no case enter into the kingdom of heaven. So this is all pretty simple. Actually, let's go to Hebrews. We're just gonna improvise. We're gonna go to Hebrews, chapter 10, we think. Verse 5. Okay, we're gonna go from there. So verse 5 reads, wherefore when he cometh into the world, he saith, sacrifice and offerings thou wouldest not, but a body hast thou prepared me. In burnt offerings and sacrifices for sin thou hast had no pleasure. Then said I, lo, I come in the volume of the book, it is written of me, to do thy will, O God. So that's actually what we were looking for. Then said I, lo, I come in the volume of the book, it is written of I. And so that's also found in Psalm 40. And it reads, So this is where it comes from. And so it reads, then said I, lo, I come in the volume of this book, it is written of me. I delight to do thy will, O my God. Yea, thy law is within my heart. I have preached righteousness in the great congregation, lo, I have not refrained my lips, O Lord, thou knowest. So, what are we trying to get to? 2 with this, we'll find out. For some reason, we feel that we gotta go to okay, so Psalm 119, Aleph. Blessed are the undefiled in the way, who walk in the law of the Lord. Blessed are they that keep his testimonies and that seek him with the whole heart. So, okay, so maybe this wasn't exactly what we were looking for, but we'll go to Yod, because we'll go to the Yod. Actually, thy hands have made me and fashioned me. Give me understanding that I may learn thy commandments. They that fear thee will be glad when they see me, because I have hoped in thy word. Alright, so we're gonna pause right there. Okay, the reason we actually went to the Yod is because the Yod is the smallest letter in the Hebrew in the Hebrew. We'll leave it at that, right? So heaven and earth, till heaven and earth pass, one jot or one tittle shall in no wise pass from the law till all be fulfilled. We're kind of trying to, we don't even know what we're trying to do, but this is kind of setting up like a foundation for what we're about to bring forth. It's easy, I say to you, that except the righteousness shall exceed, your righteousness shall exceed the righteousness of the Pharisees, the scribes and Pharisees, ye shall in no case enter into the kingdom of heaven. The scribes and Pharisees knew the scriptures. They were well learned. It's like all these scholars and peoples with doctorates and stuff like that. They are very, very well learned. Some of these priests, some of these, at least the smarter ones, the more truthful in the sense that they actually do know, or not know, but study the word. Because to know one only, well, we're not going to go into that detail, but nonetheless, the scribes were the people that wrote the scrolls and stuff like that. The Pharisees were a sect that were, you know, kind of like, we know what they're about. And so, but regardless of what kind of people they were, they knew the scriptures. But they did not believe, and so they broke a very simple commandment: take not the name of the Lord thy God in vain, which is the problem that we find amongst this world. Everyone, even if they claim to believe it, they really do not. And it's not to like make anyone less, but rather to bring this to life, to light, so that people can work on and actually come around and overcome this potentially stumbling stone and transform it into a stepping stone. And so we bring forth the fact that just like the Pharisees and the scribes, their righteousness was not righteous. To Abraham, it was counted righteousness to believe, to trust in the Almighty, that what his word said was in fact what would come to pass and true and right. And so, Yeshua, Jesus, is that word coming to pass, and the Pharisees very well knew it. The scribes very well knew it, but they didn't know it. They had studied it, they had learned it, but they were not able to know it, and therefore to relate to it. They rejected it. They proved themselves that they really did not believe or have faith in what they pretended to have faith in. You know, they they could see Jesus living and walking, and they should have been able to be acknowledgeable in the fact that this is the Word made flesh, but they were not capable of, because, you know, we don't know, like, individually what prevented each one of them to not be able to accept it, but some out of envy, some out of error, you know, whatever the case may have been, they were not able to be true. They did not have faith, and they did not believe that these things would come to pass. You know, here Yeshua is, Jesus, you know, he's doing exactly what's written, but then they ask of him a sign, as if they had not seen what had just taken place, you know. It's kind of like one standing there, and it's all like, alright, His Majesty is doing this, 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 and that, and you're reading the Bible, and you're being like, well, it says that He's going to do and be, and act in this way, and do this, and this, and that, and stuff like that, and so, but not, it can't be, and so that was the situation in which that was demonstrated by the Pharisees. They were looking at the life, at the testimony, at the living testimony made flesh, and you know, they had a good understanding of Scripture, and so they were not able to accept that these things were real, that they would actually come to pass, and so they proved being unbelievers, not really having faith in the Word, because if they really had faith, they should have been just extremely joyful to acknowledge and to be thankful to be a part of this. But they rejected Him. They rejected the facts and the clear and obvious truth, as many reject His Imperial Majesty. They don't even bother trying to discredit it, because it's undiscreditable. It is truth. Nothing else can be. People do not really have faith, and so they want to keep pretending that they believe in something, but not really expect it to happen. So we actually have a personal, like, experience. When we began to read Scripture, we started wanting to do everything that was in Scripture, and my grandmother and my mother, my guardians rather, they would look at me and ask or comment, because I would be happy to be changing in a way that was written of in Scriptures, like the fact that, like, well, basically, you know, to get to the bottom of it, you know, like, we no longer went out for whatever reason. We go to work and do whatever was, like, absolutely necessary, then go home and study Scripture. And so a comment, you know, arose, like you don't even go out, right? And we were extremely joyful to be like, well, it says here, right? It says here in Scripture that no longer should we come out, should we go out and stuff like that. And it doesn't mean that we don't go out, just there's a deeper meaning, and only them that know the truth can relate to it. And so, like, they were like, nah, but you're taking it too serious. And so, you know, we kind of looked at them, and we were like, what do you mean? Wait, you're trying to tell me that you pretend to believe or have faith in something, but you don't really gotta expect it or really gotta believe in it. You just make pretend that you believe it, but you don't expect these things to be so, to be acted or to be practiced or to be made manifest. And they kind of, like, stayed quiet looking at me, and they kind of, you know, kind of went like, yeah. They didn't say anything, but their heads nodded yes. And we're like, we laughed. We just kind of like, huh, that's pretty funny. And so we took off. You know, they know not what they're even saying, but that's the righteousness of the Pharisees and of the scribes. You know, believe and, you know, and verify. We challenge ones to, you know, all these things are taking place, but the people don't want to believe. You don't want to believe that what you preach and read of will actually come to pass. And so you just, nah. You were just rejected, like Yeshua was rejected. You know, the whole volume is written of me. That's Jesus. And so you know, have no fear. Be of a good courage, we would say, because if you believe and trust in the Almighty, then your righteousness is one that far exceeds the righteousness of the scribes and Pharisees and stuff like that, because you've accepted Jah's word and you've not taken it in vain. That's what we accept, to be taking the name of the Almighty in vain. A lot of people think that it's saying it in a negative sense. A lot of people have a lot of ideas. We'll bring forth this pretty accurate interpretation. Vanity is non-existent. It's false. It's an illusion. Truth is real, whether it be physical or spiritual or whatever kind of description you want to put along to it. Truth is truth, no matter what. And so, I am that which I am. But he will be. To take the name in vain is to pretend that he will not be. Anything that is spoken of him, the whole word is written of him. He will be that which he will be. But he is something. And okay, this is kind of, we're finding difficulties explaining this. Alright, so what we're trying to say is he is not nothing. He is real. He's amongst us. He says, look for me, search me out, seek me with thy whole heart. I am amongst you. Yeshua never left. Jesus never left. Always with thy and I. So, when you take his name in vain, you don't expect him to interact with you. You see, the difference between Yeshua, Jesus Christos, as I and I God, is that no other God interacts with his people, and then on top of that sacrifices his life and dies for his people and is amongst his people at all times. No other God can do that, you know. And so where I am, there you will be. Even you see me, I'll be gone for a while, you won't see me, but then, you know, you should be glad I go to the Father. And so we here do testify, you know, His Imperial Majesty, the Father, you know, and we see Christ in Him. And the reason we can see Christ is because where Christ is, we are, and stuff like that. But basically, like He's a God that is amongst us. He's not far from us, you know. And so, never, ever, as Rastafari, expect God. Well, it's impossible, right? But to other peoples, never expect the God that you believe in. Don't expect Him not to be in your life, you know. So look for Him, and behold, Rastafari. So yeah, we'll basically conclude with that. That's our opinion, our position and thought as to what taking the name of the Almighty in vain actually means. You know, He's real. I am a man. You know, touch me. You know, so we say, try His Imperial Majesty, the Father, the Almighty, you know, in and through Yeshua. Moshiach, Christ in His kingly character, you know. The manifestation and the word made flesh in these latter days, you know. So that's all we have to do. Accept it, verify it, and surely your righteousness should have exceeded that of the scribes and Pharisees, which really don't expect anything to happen and don't really believe in what they say or what they read or what Jah has said, for that matter. So, see. Shalom Rastafari.